Now we talk about correlated random walk. Now this is the underlying staple of Monte Carlo simulation for quantitative risk. So if anyone says that they are doing Monte Carlo simulation, they are probably doing correlated random walk. So let us give an example. So say you start with three variables which you think their prices are linked, say steel, cast iron and wrought iron. So you expect the shocks to be correlated. So you expect if there is a positive shock to steel, it is also going to impact cast iron and wrought iron, or there is a shock to cast iron, that shock is also immediately going to impact steel and wrought iron. So things like this. So say this is steel, XT is the steel, this is the random walk associated with steel, this is the random walk associated with cast iron, and this is the random walk associated with wrought iron. So this is a standard random walk model. The only difference is now these three are correlated. So correlated means that they come from a normal distribution with mean zero, and you have a covariance matrix where this sigma is the variance covariance matrix. So we are putting X as steel, this Y as cast iron, and this Z as wrought iron. So X, Y, Z. So you build a matrix like this. So we have to first build this matrix sigma. So this sigma is nothing but variance of X, covariance of XY, covariance of XZ, covariance YX, covariance of Y, covariance of YZ. This is covariance of ZX, covariance of ZY, and then variance of Z. So this can be easily done in R. So you don't have to do much in R. You just feed in the data of X, Y, and Z, and R will help you compute these variances and covariances. So covariance command is covariance XY, and the variance command is variance of, say, X. So we are going to see this in the built-in data set in R called Iris. And now let us see in R how to compute this covariances and variances. So once you compute this covariance and variance, you fill this matrix sigma. So you will get some numbers and you fill those numbers in here. So we are going to use this Iris data. I'm writing head Iris 4 because we just want to see the first four lines. Although we will use the entire data set, I just want to display the first four lines. So the Iris data set has four columns, which is full of data. One is sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width. So we want to find the variance and the covariance. So we are just going to find the covariance between first two columns. So that is Iris sepal length and Iris sepal width. So this is the covariance command. So very simple, you just select this and run it, and you get the covariance between two columns. And if you want to get variance, just type variance of this sepal length and then run this, and you get the variance. If you take covariance of sepal length with covariance of just sepal length, you will again get the variance. So that is it. So you have all these you get all these values, and you can plug them in right here. So you plug those values which you get right here, variance and covariances, you plug them in here. So once you plug them in here, you get a variance covariance matrix. And this is what we are going to use in R to simulate a correlated random walk.